Hello guys. So, a quick little walk around for you in Adrian's car. You could see this car in the 2019 EMMA UK Finals playlist on YouTube, right? We could see this car over there, but then now you can see a few little changes. It's a work in progress car. This is not one of those builds where everything is fully finished and looking pretty. It's about having a functional system for daily driving, and then as and when we have time, then we do little things, right?
Yeah.
Pretty much, because these things take a long time, and then having one day here, one day there, that doesn't really give enough time for you to do changes. So I can't show what's underneath that panel because that box is heavy. So underneath we have a Zabco ST6X SQ 6-channel amp running the front end, and a ST1350XM monoblock running the sub with a Zabco DSP4 Mark II DSP doing the processing. One day we will have the sub in the spare rear well because it's quite deep. We can make a custom box there and make a fourth floor with cutouts nicely, so we can display the sub, we can display the amps and the equipment, light them in a simple way, and then it will be pretty. Now we just swap the sub out, because before we had the K12, and Adrian wanted a bit more low end, still keeping nice and tight, accurate response, but just a bit more body and the capability to go a bit crazier if needed. Right? So I've used this Q12 in many cars and it always delivers, and for the money, it's really difficult to beat it, honestly, because it's like, what, 325, something like that? Dual 2-ohm voice call, it can take a kilowatt, and it can take it, and it plays low. In this short Mercedes coupe, it's rather a short car like a Golf, it still plays pretty low, but we have this same sub inverted in the Vectra, you could see in a video, and in that car it plays even lower with even more authority under 25 hertz because it's a longer car. But having said that, even in this car, I think the difference from the K12 is pretty big. Yeah, okay, that's a cheap sub. It's like 120 quid or something like that. For an entry level 12 inch sub, it's okay. Yeah, you can see this box is not even beautiful, but it's well constructed. It's rigid, it's solid. It has seen many changes before. Like you can see a hot glue patch there because that's where it used to have this beacon connector, because in his previous car it was facing forwards and the connector was behind the seat, it wasn't visible. Now it was always hanging out, cable coming out, plugged in here, and it was just always a pain in the ass. So we took it out, sealed it, put the connector to the back, and it has big brackets at the back, so three brackets along the back of the panel, so it's rigid, and there's still pretty good practical space. You just have to be careful because there's no grill now, but other than that. So up front, there's quite a mismatch of everything. Let's turn it down just for a sec. So Adrian had these DLS Iridium tweeters for how many years now?
6-7 years.
It's a long time. It has seen how many cars? Three cars, or just the previous? Yeah. So it's been traveling from car to car. They are pretty good tweeters. We are going to change them soon though, but they've been doing a good job. And we have those tiny little Audible Physics cheapest 2-inch drivers. I don't even remember the model of it.
CP2?
Yeah, they were like dirt cheap. I don't know, $50-$60 a pair. And it was never really on retail in UK either. But these cheap pairs have always worked pretty well in these steel pods. They can run tweeterless as well, but yeah, having tweeters, it's always an advantage when it's tuned well. Here we had the Audible Physics Ram 6As before, so now we swap them out to, it's getting boring, but those drivers are bloody awesome, to the Micro Precision 5 Series mid-bass drivers. And they are very, very musical, just like in the Vectra, we did the same swap from a different driver. And those Micro Precision 5 series in my demo wall as well over there, and I had that in the Megane, the Megane car we built last September, where I fitted it through the floor in true IB. These drivers like a lot of airspace. They are very musical. It's the go-to mid-bass driver. Anything under like 600 quid, I would go with those, and they cost only 350 a pair. But honestly, it's not about the money. It's how it works, it's how it plays music. It's very musical. It can play low as well if needed, but you cross it at like 60 hertz and it can cope with output as well. But it's very responsive, it's very transient and accurate. That's what matters when you want to play music accurately. There you can see this Zabco controller. Now we are streaming. It just, hang on, jump in for a quick one. There you go. Shut the door.
I walk along the levee, see the gypsy man. Dirt neath my feet, baby, turning to quicksand. You looked into my palm, then looked me in the eye, told me you were gone over the rise. Once we stood together,
The trunk was open
at the wishing well.
Bass is just so tight and there's no overhang.
Once upon a time,
so easy to tune in and get the staging right with them.
Tommy used to work on the docks. The union went on strike. He's down on his luck. It's tough. It's tough. Put a spell on you. You better stop the things you do.
You can see, you know, when people say that I only show high-end builds, this is nothing crazy. It's accessible for anyone. Those pillars are not even finished, just literally self-adhesive carpet on the pillar, you know, but it's working, it sounds good, and you can enjoy it every day until we make it pretty. Just because some people can't imagine having something unfinished and something looking like this, but enjoying the music is not about what it looks like. That's what people should forget forever, because they'd rather want to have a really pretty looking pillar with badly aimed speakers. They don't even care how it's tuned, how it sounds, but it looks pretty with fancy looking laser, you know, made drills and whatnot.
For a reason, to make us strong.
Sounds good even outside. Why wouldn't it? If it sounds good inside, it should sound good outside. Yeah. Simple daily system. There you go, guys. You can see it's doable. It's not even moving. Well, if you whack it up, then it does, but. That it will distort on the mic as hell. Oops. So this is it, guys. Hope you like this video. It gives a bit of inspiration for some of you to do something simple, good sounding in your cars. As you can see, plenty, well, use the right equipment and get it tuned. That's all it takes. Feel free to share it, subscribe to the channel, all the usual things, and I will see you in the next one.